vehicle on fire?
Might as well be.
It's looking like it might be electrical.
We have fire department personnel en route to you, sir. Please stay away from the garage. Stand by.
Stage 3. Now it's time to see how dedicated this car guy really is.
What kind of car is it?
What, are you stupid? Dodge Challenger.
What year, sir?
2010.
2010 Challenger. That's why I rolled it out. I'm a car guy, too.
Yeah, could have fooled me. You didn't know the kind of car it was.
I'll try to do some research for that, sir. I'm just a little busy saving your house.
I don't give about the house.
You don't care about the house? You care about the car more?
Hell yeah.
Bingo.
Well, then I guess I can come on out and let you know what's going on.
Hey, David, I think I figured out the problem. You're on Overhauling.
Overhaul.
That's me. Gotcha.
Yeah.
Oh, congratulations, man. All right, another successful Overhauling prank. The cat is out of the bag, and I think the shock level is a solid 10. David, how are you feeling right now?
Stunned. I didn't know what was going on, and the car was on fire. Is it on fire? Is the house on fire? How did this happen? How did they get in the garage?
How did you feel when you guys came around that corner and you saw what was happening?
Stunned. My 2010 Dodge Challenger that's never been washed, now, all of a sudden, now it's on fire? How?
My favorite thing that you said was, I don't give a bleep about the house. I only care about the car. It shows what a true car guy you are.
Oh, yeah. Well, waxed to the point where I can't see the pearl. And now look at it.
Well, this is definitely the before. The after is going to be a lot better.
Okay.
Next, out comes the tape. Chip's idea for the graphics will give a nod to the original 70s Challenger, but of course, it'll be one of a kind.
It's amazing to see what Chip can do with a roll of tape. This is a testament to how his dad, Sam Foose, taught him to work. It's not about relying on precision instruments. It's about trusting your eye.
I think the greatest thing about this is it's not going to be vinyl anymore. It's paint, and it'll look so much better.
All right, standing under David's Challenger right now, Preston is preparing to change out the shocks and the springs. In order to do that, though, we got to get access to them, so he's got to drop out the entire rear end. So he's got that going right now. Tons of modifications going on performance-wise under the car. In addition to the shocks and springs, the exhaust and the brakes are also going to be brand new.
Are we touching?
Yeah. We're on the frame in the back. Ooh. All right, I guess we should go through a little status update. I mean, we're getting closer and closer to final reassembly of the Challenger, but what are the major steps that we still have to accomplish?
Well, I believe all of the suspension is on. We've got the wheels here. Tires are in, but I want to change the tire size, so we're making a little alteration there. We've still got the interior to go in. We've got to put the supercharger and then get it all back together.
And I know that new brakes still need to go on all four corners, so he's getting major performance upgrade in this with a little bit of design upgrade with
exactly.
Thanks to your touches.
Like I say, once we get it all done, then you know what we've got to do with it.
Drop it and rock it.
And give it back to David.
Oh, that's right. I don't get to keep it?
No.
Damn.
Well, Hector just brought over the seats for the Challenger. These are beautiful. Can't wait to get them in the car.
All right, so Eric's got the pry bar. He's gonna push down on the lower suspension, and it's out with the old. Thank you, Preston. Oh, beautiful. And in with the new.
That's it.
Voila. It's getting more beautiful by the second.
Just ripped out the old exhaust system. I'm gonna put this brand new system in there. Brand new brakes, front and rear. Once that's done, we're gonna drop the car down, putting that Pro Charger in there.
Okay, it's a moment of truth. Hope everything works. So let's fire it up and see what we got.
Yeah.
So far, so good.
Nice.
All right, here we go. Final piece. The hood is going on. Looks beautiful, guys. Ready?
Got him close.
Turned out to be pretty good, huh? Me coming to your house.
Absolutely. totally surprised.
Welcome to the Overhauling family.
Thank you. Thank you.
There you go. How has it been since we took your car out in Arizona?
For some odd reason, I get up every day at 4 o'clock, and that never happens. I'm on the internet at 4 o'clock in the morning looking at Overhauling, all the cars that Chip Foose has done, trying to figure out where's he going with this.
Did you come up with anything?
It's gonna be badass.
Check.
It's gonna be a Mopar, a real Mopar car.
Well, there's a bunch of Easter eggs that I think you're gonna have a lot of fun finding too.
Oh, cool.
We love how much your family means to you. Not only your wife, Amy, but obviously your mom too, and how much enjoyment she got out of the car with you. And so that was a big part of our motivation in making this car so special for you. Are you ready for your day to get a whole lot better?
Absolutely.
All right, go ahead and open your eyes.
Wow. Yo. That is really stunning. Phew. God. I mean, literally, it almost felt like I was gonna pass out. The legs got wobbly. It was that overwhelming. I never felt like that. I really felt like I was gonna pass out. Wow. And my son. He's in a large explosion, and it separates his brain from his skull, and he can't get rid of the PTSD. And that's the next fire I gotta put out. Boy, my mom. Phew. I'd put her in this seat, and I'd go on the on-ramp, and I would gun it. And just that force of going back was a thrill for her. She can see this now.
Chip?
Well, first of all, pleasure to meet you, David.
Likewise. Chip and the A-Team, I'd like to thank you for the great job that you have done. I will never, ever forget it, and this car will be in my family for the rest of my life.